Let's look at some applications of those laws of motion now. Starting off, it's fairly simple and understanding more and more as we go along. If a net force of magnitude 20 newtons is applied to a block of mass 2.5 kilograms, what will be the magnitude of the acceleration? So we're just going to use the fact that F net equals ma, as we saw in the second law of motion. And they're telling us here that there's a net force of 20 newtons on this object, and its mass is 2.5 kilograms. We use all the standard units, and newtons and kilograms are the standard units. And if we solve this, we get an answer of 8, which is in the standard units of meters per second squared. So there we go. That is the answer. A car is driving along the highway at 100 kilometers per hour, and the engine of the car through the wheels, through actually what we'll see later called static friction of the wheels, pushes it forward with a force of 2.4 kilonewtons. 2.4 kilonewtons is 2,400 newtons. We're going to want to change that to 2,400 because we have to use standard units. What is the force of air resistance on the car? Oh, wait a minute. We don't even have to do any calculations. So maybe we don't have to really do any conversions here, because what we have here is a car that is traveling along at 100 kilometers per hour. Now, the thing about the 100 kilometers per hour is that the context of this description just tells us that it's going at a constant speed. The actual speed doesn't matter. All that matters is that saying that it's going at 100 kilometers per hour tells us that the acceleration is zero. And as we said on the other page, if an object is not accelerating, if it keeps doing what it was doing before, then the net force on it must be zero. So somehow or other, it's being pushed forward through the engine applied through the wheels with a force of 2.4 kilonewtons. So that means that there must be a force going the other way, and the dominant force affecting cars that are traveling along the highway is air resistance, and it must be pushing the other way with a force of 2.4 kilonewtons so that you can have an acceleration of zero, so that these two forces balance each other out and the net force is zero. I've put here a negative sign in front of it to make it clear that it is in the negative direction. It's in the opposite direction of this force. It's in the other way. Now we have a cart pulled forward with a force of 53 newtons, while the friction in the wheels resists the motion with a force of 27 newtons. What will be the acceleration of the 16 kilogram cart? Okay, it can be helpful to draw a little diagram here. Later on, we'll make it clear that these diagrams I'm drawing are actually a standard thing that we use to analyze the forces in an object. They're called free body diagrams. And what we do is we draw the object, a very simple version of the object. We don't actually draw what it looks like. We draw a simple shape and show the forces acting on that object. So it's being pulled forward with a force of 53 newtons. So I'm going to put the 53 newtons. While the friction in the wheels resists the motion. So if forward is this way, it's being pulled in that direction. To resist the motion means to be pulling back the other way with a force of 27 newtons. Let's see. It has an acceleration. What will be the acceleration of the 16 kilogram cart? So this is 16 kilograms. And another thing that could be helpful is to show which way it's going to accelerate. I'm expecting it to accelerate in that direction. Yes. So I'm going to use this second law of motion that says F net equals ma. And F net is the overall sum, the overall effect of all of the forces taking into account their direction, so that some of them might be in opposite directions. And when they're in opposite directions, that 27 newtons is going to partially cancel out that 53 newtons. And the way to deal with that is to simply look for any forces that are in the same direction as the way it looks like it is going to accelerate. And that's the 53. So there's 53 in the positive direction. We're using the normal positive direction, but we're going to get in the habit of showing the acceleration and using that as the positive direction. So this is the normal to the right positive direction, but sometimes we'll change that to a different direction. And so going against it is the 27 newtons. And so that's the overall force altogether. The net force is 53 trying to pull it to the right, which is being reduced by 27, which is trying to pull back the other way. And that's equal to 16A. So 53 minus 26, 7 is 26 equals 16A. A is equal to 26 divided by 16. which is 1.63. And because I use the standard units of newtons and kilograms, I know that my answer is going to be in the standard units of meters per second squared. Now we have Billy is standing on a frictionless cart, a hoverboard maybe. And Billy throws a ball with a force of 52 newtons. The mass of the ball is 225 grams, and the mass of Billy and the cart he is standing on is 26 kilograms. Well, he's throwing the ball. What will be the ball's acceleration, and what will be Billy's acceleration? Okay, so Billy is throwing a ball. Let's look at Billy first, because the answer for Billy is here first. So here we have Billy. Let's just imagine that Billy is throwing the ball this way. Here's the ball, and Billy's going to try to throw it in that direction. So what's happening if Billy is trying to throw the ball in that direction? Okay, what the heck? I'm going to draw the ball first. There's the ball. The ball is being pushed that way with a force of 42 newtons. But back here was Billy. And what's happening to Billy? Well, if Billy is pushing on the ball with a force of 42 newtons, then the third law of motion tells us the ball is pushing back on Billy with a force of 42 newtons. This gets a little getting used to, because sometimes we think, wait a minute, is the ball pushing back on Billy just as hard as Billy's pushing back on the ball? And the answer is absolutely yes, and it seems wrong, but when we get to the answer, hopefully it'll help you see how this can make sense. In both cases, we use F net equals ma. When I look at Billy, the only force I see acting on Billy is the 42. It looks like Billy then is going to have to accelerate in this direction. So I'm going to consider to the left to be the positive direction for Billy. So that's 42 newtons. That's equal to Billy's mass and the cart he's on, which is 26 times A. So A is equal to 42 divided by 26, which is 1.62. Because I used all the standard units in my calculations, my final answer will be in the standard units of meters per second squared. So Billy's going to accelerate at 1.62 meters per second squared. But what about the ball? It also has a force, and it also follows the second law of motion, which says F net equals ma. So in the ball's case, it's going to accelerate this way. It's going to accelerate to the right. So the right will be the positive direction. We'll put 42. There's nothing going the other way to in any way take away from that 42. That's equal to the mass, which is in kilograms. We have to convert to kilograms, so that we're dealing with standard units. And now that we're in standard units, we can just divide 42 divided by the 0.225, and I get 187 meters per second squared. So when something big like a person exerts a force on a ball, which is small, we have trouble sometimes accepting that they're both feeling the same amount of force, because we see the ball being affected in a much more dramatic way than the person. But that's not because the ball is getting less force, more force. It's because the ball has less mass, whereas the person has a very big mass. So with the same force, you get very different accelerations, because even though they both feel the same amount of force, each of them in the opposite direction, the one with the smaller force, the smaller mass, has a much bigger acceleration as a result. So we see a much greater effect, which doesn't mean that the force was bigger, it just means that it was a smaller object, so it was affected much more dramatically by that force.